scriptures come from 2 Timothy chapter 1, verses 1 through 14. I, Paul, am on special assignment for Christ, carrying out God's plan laid out in the message of life by Jesus. I write this to you, Timothy, the son I love so much. All the best from our God and Christ be yours. Every time I say your name in prayer, which is practically all the time, I thank God for it. The God I worship with my whole life in the tradition of my ancestors. I miss you a lot, especially when I remember that last tearful goodbye, and I look forward to a joy-packed reunion. That precious memory triggers another, your honest faith, and what a rich faith it is. Handed down from your grandmother, Lord, to your mother, Eunice, and now to you, and the special gift of ministry you receive when I lay hands on you and pray. Keep that ablaze. God doesn't want us to be shy with his gifts, but bold and loving and sensible.
Yes,
so don't be embarrassed to speak up for our master or for me, his prisoner. Take your share of suffering for the message along with the rest of us. We can only keep on going. After all, by the power of God, who first saved us and then called us to his holy work. We had nothing to do with it. It was only by him. He prepared for us in Jesus long before we knew anything about it. But we know it now. Since the appearance of our Savior, nothing could be planned. Death defeated, life vindicated in a steady blaze of light, all through the work of Jesus. This is the message I've been sent apart to proclaim as preacher and missionary and teacher. It's also the cause of all this trouble I'm in. But I have no regrets. I couldn't be more sure of my ground. The one I trusted in can take care of what he's trusted me to do right to the end. So keep at your work. This faith and love rooted in Christ, that I have out for you, is as sound as the day you first heard it from me. Guard this precious thing placed in your custody by the Holy Spirit who works in us. May God bless you to the reader, hearer, and the doer of the word.
Amen. Amen.